I'm genuinely concerned by the absolute slowness of YouTube streaming pages today. Absolute chaos. Oh well, pretty sure everything's sorted now. Just stick that on top, and we're good to go. Today we're going to be playing Blue Blink, or AOI Blink, a Japan-only PC Engine game, or what would have been the TurboGrafx-16 for English-speaking countries. It's based on the last animated series that Osamu Tezuka was involved with before his unfortunate and sad departure in the early 90s. This particular game is quite interesting because I'm pretty sure the game itself came out after his death, so I don't think he had much involvement with this one. But it's interesting. I hate to start on an already negative point, but today's been one of them negative days. Okay, I'll take you through what's going on. We got three playable characters here. Usually we have about three playable characters in this game. You have a weapon or attack, and then if you press the select button, you switch to another character, and they've got their own attack as well. Now, I tend to, even though this guy is pretty impressive, his movement is generally pretty awful, so I tend to just play as the main guy. Yay, welcome, Soy! Is the stream working for you? Because I was having trouble with the stream page when I started, but it seems to be behaving now. This is Blue Blink, the last game based on a Osamu Tezuka license to come out or to be in development during his lifetime. It's quite interesting. Excellent, so you've got decent stream speed, because I was genuinely worried I might have to... Stupid teddy bears. I was worried I might have to stream in something less than 720p, but luckily it's behaving itself. No, this is not for Mega Drive. This is for the TurboGrafx-16, or PC Engine. Right, we need that key. That key is very important later on. And we need to take the up route. I'll sort of explain what's going on as we go, but this game has multiple routes. And depending on how you complete an area, it depends on where you go. And I'm pretty sure it's here we have to go in order to beat this world, so... I'll just sort of take us through what's going on. I don't know much about this game, because when I last played it, it was before I discovered the translation hack. Yep, Japan only, but patched into English by Gaijin Productions. We're going to take the upper route again. And Zobos Hacks or something? I should really have that information to hand. All I have to say is it was translated by some wonderful people on the internet. So we can all enjoy... AOA Blink. Or Blue Blink. As long as it's not King Mike, you're good for translations. Oh, goddamn King Mike. How dare you ruin Time Zone so bad? I'm assuming that's King Mike. Yeah, we just need the key from here. Now, that is something that's very easy to miss, and you need it in order to beat the game, so... Well, in order to beat this world, so... You know. Yeah. Jump over. My good friend, with the red key, you can get into the boss lair. Have you found it yet? It's on the top floor. It's okay, I found it. Yes, time zone. Yay, auto-scrolling level! So, you probably weren't here when I showed this off. Each character has their own specific attack. Now, you can switch between them at will. This guy's got the best attack, but his movement's not so great. Like, you see his jump is pretty stunted, but then when you switch to the main guy, his movement's pretty decent, so I tend to go for the main guy just on account of his jump height and movement speed. Like, the fact that this is an auto-scroller isn't really much of a problem if you just scroll along by yourself anyway. But yeah, this one's really interesting. I was surprised to find out when I started playing it that it was Japan only. When I originally discovered the game, I thought there's no way this would be a Japan only. It's so good. It would surely come out, but it didn't. All right, time to open the boss lair. Now, the majority of boss battles in this game, you get to be on Blink's back, which makes things a lot better. Because he is overpowered. Now, I'm surprised you haven't made a comment on the picture down in the bottom left yet. There was certainly a lot of subtle themes in Blue Blink, the cartoon. Maybe I'm just looking for them because I'm a crude adult, but there were a lot of suggestive themes in that cartoon. Thank you. If you don't mind, they're all mine. And sorry, Blink, but your princess is in another castle. You beat the Masked Sun. It's probably because of Blink, though. Oh! Oh! Roasted! With him, you can save your dad. Oh, never mind. Your dad is in another castle. I saw the picture and thought classic ERB. I didn't mean to come back to this level. Well, you see, I could just do this. But where's the fun in that? Where's the fun in that? Exactly. I rest my case. we're keeping it on there because there's no fun in just having the game box there. Oh, I'm gonna have to re-enable the window. There we go. So I didn't mean to play this level again. I'm not sure there's much eating going on, to be honest. Well, actually, I don't know what them kids call it these days. I'll get that anyway, whatever that is. Okay, now I can move along. Ivory Castle. Doesn't look like much of a castle. What do you have to say? Did you find your dad? I am sure that you'll, with no apostrophe, find him. I'm sure I will. Now, where's the key in this world? I want to go down, because I want to be on the place with the bridge, so I need to go down. I'm pretty sure it's in the bridge level in this world. It's been a while since I played this, so I'm having to remember where each key was. Which isn't easy. My pot! That sounds so bad out of context as well. Down, down. Oh, it was only coins. What a waste of a key. Anyway, we don't want to go in that door because we want to carry on down, so I'm pretty sure we have to keep going through the level. To this one. Up ahead, there are many pits. Blink will help you if you fall. Well, isn't that Blink so fucking amazing? I hate him. Alright, this level I have a pink, silly haired princess helping me for some reason. I'm curious what she's like, so I'm going to switch to her. Oh, yes. Good jump. Very good jump. But no attack. Right, okay, so she gives up any ability to attack in exchange for good control and movement. Okay, well, that's worth it. In the next area, a red key is... Yes! Yes, 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 yes! I remembered well. When it gets to World 3 and World 4, it's going to be harder to remember where the key is, but I remembered it was in this area. Some of these games, I've played them way too much. But, you know, then I still never do a feature on them. Which just seems weird. Oh, no. No, no, no. I got poison. Oh, no, I got poisoned. Give me the heart. The heart didn't help. Alright. That unpoisoned me. I'm not gonna grab poison again. Not if I can help it. I get up there. Oh, of course. That's right. That which increases my movement speed. Oh, great. I picked up poison again. Brilliant. Gee, thanks, Blink. Nope, that's not key. I think I've missed the key. Anyone find the red key yet? Maybe this paper will give us a hint. Look by a door. Thanks. Well, what I'll do is I'll go there and then I'll come back and I'll have another look at it. But I tell ya, I don't know what's in there. Trump 2016. Search by a door. Okay. Well, there's few doors in this place, so... Oh, oh, oh. There we go. Thank you. Right, to the boss level. I found it! Alright, we can take the crossroads right here to the boss level. Ivory Castle. Right, I don't remember much about the boss of this world. I might once I start fighting it. Oh god! Make it stop! Eventually this game just becomes running, like, jump and shoot. It becomes Mega Man, basically. Like this. Right. To the boss! No, this isn't, wait, no, maybe. This is bringing back some memories. Damn it! Game over. Well, we'll cont from the start of this world. I'm gonna need a drink first. Let's see if you can guess what I'm drinking this time. Is it cider? Is it hooch? Is it lager? No, it's a bottle of water. Fascinating. I'm drinking water. It's truly the stream of the future. Did you find your dad? No. I was too busy getting mauled to death by some snakes. But not again. I'm not gonna fall for it this time. And that poison trick might work on an idiot, but not on me. Up ahead, there are many pits. Yes. Yes, there are. There are many pits. Come on, Blink. Let's open that. What's in there? Yeah, that'll do. To the next area. Alright, I know where the key's hidden now. So there's no more fooling around. Anyone find the red key yet? Maybe this paper will give us a hint. I've already got it. But thank you. What? I'm not going that way. Let me... Oh. Seriously? I could go up from there last time. Why has that changed? Why are you forcing me to go to this area? Okay, well, fine. We'll do the level we somehow managed to skip last time? I guess? Honestly thought this area wasn't mandatory, but there you go. Now that's poison. That's poison. I know poison when I see it. Just gonna wait for the poison to disappear first. Oh, I see. Healthy things, like health and coins, disappear, but poison doesn't. Fine, I'll just jump over it then. Yep, gotta have nondescript slimes. Well, that was a chest that contained a key, and that was a chest that contained a key, and that's a chest that contained a key. Why would you lock a chest if it has a key in it? There's no poison in these people. Oh, God. You've already got a key, right? Try opening all the chests for goodies. Oh, thanks. Yeah, I know how to play the game, asshole. Okay. This time I'm not gonna fail this one. Like a bloody idiot. I'm gonna try not to use save states. If I have to, I really will. But I don't really want to. It goes against, like, every part of my moral code. Oh, well, this is a good place to farm money, I guess. Hopefully, I won't need it. Quick save. Alright. There's no rhyme or reason to this. There's no guessable pattern. Fine. You want a save state stream? You've got one. Given how limited a system it like the TurboGrafx, the PC Engine is, I would not be surprised if that was the case, Soy. That all the programming costs went into making these heads look cool. This is when I find out there's some super secret attack that Blink can do. I dread to think what music that would be, Soy. Quack, 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 quack. Come on. Is it really got to the point where I have to do this in order to win? This is when I find out that, like, just standing still and holding attack is more effective. No, look, the attack's absolutely homing on me. I misread that for a second. If I do my health revival on the pause screen, I get more health back than if I let my health run down. So it looks like I'm putting in a cheat, but I'm not. I'm actually just sacrificing the life I'm on to get more health, rather than letting myself run down and get less health back. Because that's how stupid the way this game operates. that I get more health back if I, say, refill my health than I do if I die. I still use my life up, but I get more health back. It's silly. Oh, that's really worth all the hard work and effort. Yellowtown. I'm wondering if comments from, like, if comments from 20 minutes ago are just coming up, or if generally you have some reason to say roasted. Because I know I said it a while ago. Right, I'm just gonna have to kill myself off in this area, because, because I've only got one life and I've got to try and do the whole world with it, which is just ridiculous. Come on, there's got to be like a pit or something I can fall down. They've even made it so it's hard to kill yourself off. When you want to die, it's really hard. When you don't want to die... No point character, yeah. Oh, so you were paying attention at the very least. I'll give you that. The effort I have to go to get a game over. Right, okay. Now let's start this world properly. How many blue keys do you have? Every chest needs a key. Thanks. Right. I'm gonna hazard a guess that the key is hidden at them totem poles, because that is scary. Oh no, it could be hidden at the underground area, couldn't it? Right, I guess it's time to go exploring and find out where these keys are hidden. Yay. Yellowtown, let's go. Right. Let's play this for real now. Are those armadillos, bears, and birds? Yes, your mum is a boss. They are. And I'm never going to get tired of saying your name. Ever. This is Aoi Dillos, yes. I misread that as well. I'm just having trouble reading what you write today, sorry. This is Aoi Blink, or Blue Blink. It was released exclusively in Japan for the PC Engine. And it was based on an Osamu Tezuka cartoon, the same guy who did Astro Boy. I'm pretty sure that the cartoon in question was the last thing that he worked on before his death. In fact, I think they finished the show without him in the end. Onwards! Oh. I got two doors. Two doors, up or down. I can take a swig of Highland Spring while I'm waiting. Do I have any chewing gum left? No. Still no. Keys are not chewing gum. Damn it. Mesmerized by the weirdness of the game. Well then, I am going to have to say up. If you're going ahead, watch out. It is very dangerous. Make sure to... be on the lookout for a red key hidden in a jar! Yes! We're going the right way. Basically, I have to find the red key. It's hidden in one level in each world. And you need to have the red key in order to access the boss battle. So, right, this level has moles that are really irritating. And a bridge that falls apart. No, I've never taken the time to see what it is I'm firing. I think they're stars. Right, there is a chest hidden on that geyser down there, but I can't open it because I don't have a key. Mesmerized by that overly friendly horse. You're not going to be happy until I remove that picture, are you? I mean, come on, I could do this and have the game artwork here, but why would I do that? The cartoon had such obvious overtones that I think it's very important the whole world knows that this boy was in love with this unicorn pony space creature thing. It was blatant. It was blatant in the goddamn show. It was there, right, plain as day. So I'm gonna leave it up. Throwing stars. But curiously, each character has a different attack. This guy, tomatoes, I guess, and then this guy, green fireballs. I like this guy best because bronies were around before bronies were around. Yes, Keshi Head, they were. Although, I am exaggerating this game's overtones a little. Right, that was obviously a bad route to take. I'm not going to do that again. But I do have a key now, which means I can see what's in this chest by the geyser here. Oh, just money. Just money, guys. Just money. Not gonna fall down that way this time. Didn't we already do this in Sailor Moon? Well, Wordsworth Guidance sprung to mind for me. But I suppose there was some in Sailor Moon as well. Ah, poison! Damn it! I hate poison. Poison is the worst part of this game. Like, you know, Bill Bev DeVoe, or whatever his name is. Why am I still poisoned? Damn it! What is this Alice Cooper nonsense? Come on. I guess this is the way to go. Before you leave, please listen. You should probably change formation in the next area. There's traps there too. Be careful. I'm pretty sure that's a quote from that, actually. Yeah, I remember that. Yes, we are thinking of the same thing. Oh. Arrows. Oh my god, it jumped down. Oh man. Okay, I was not expecting that. That floor is gonna fall apart. Look at it. Yeah. I'm worried that this conversation will just turn into lewdness for the sake of lewdness. Here's the thing, right? Have you been watching my Sushi Bites show, Keshi Head and Your Mum? Have you been watching Sushi Bites? Because I was actually thinking about doing for Sushi Bites an episode on Inju Gakuen, which people probably know better as La Blue Girl. I wrote a script for it and everything, and then never got round to editing it. Hi, Paper Mario! This is for the PC Engine. Released exclusively in Japan, but this is an English translation. The boss is up ahead. I heard his key is hidden somewhere in the mountains. Great. If it's hidden in the mountains, I have no choice but to take the other route out of town and go up. Nobody knows half of the stuff I'm talking about. Thanks, Soy. Just because you don't know. I made a very good discovery today. The members of my chat know what Wordsworth Kindness is, so you know what? You learn something new every day. And I'm very pleased that my audience knows what these things are. Well, who doesn't know about it? It's only like the most well-known of its ilk. You know, it's right up there with everything else. Oh boy. I recorded a script for a La Blue Girl episode of Sushi Bites, and then I decided not to do it because I felt it just wasn't in with the tone of the show. Now, you're probably thinking, but the show does enough lewd games, it would hardly be an issue, but I talked about some very deep things in that show, including Japanese censorship laws, so I've decided ultimately not to go with it. Okay, one issue is that this looked like mountains on the world map, but it's clearly not, is it? So what am I meant to do? Aha! Think this is meant to be a kid's game? It certainly isn't, like, difficulty-wise. Okay, hoist me up there. No, that's just money. Excellent! The first anime DVD you ever bought was...
That is around here somewhere in one of my bags. That particular movie, yep.
Well, it's interesting you should mention that, actually, because it was, I'm pretty sure it was the same person behind that. You've been initiated, your mum is a boss. You've been initiated into the world of Inju Gakuen, my friend. It only goes downhill from here. Before you know it, it's Bible Black, then it's Night Shift Nurses, and then you're in real trouble. I don't know, you can't really go much worse than Urotsuki Doji, to be honest. Right, there is another route out of this level. There has to be. Digimon the movie. Now, if we're talking about, like, anime DVDs, like, that I owned first, yeah, probably one of the Pokemon movies. Maybe Pokemon 2000? But if we're talking about anime DVDs and not just kids' adaptations of anime... God. Game over! Game over. Right, okay, well, I did the mountains, and there wasn't anything there, so do I go down? I mean, that doesn't look like a mountain to me. That looks like a staircase leading down. I've not heard of that one, but I'll just make a note of it. Notepad? That requires some research. Right, Yellow Town. Try this again.
Hey, I wouldn't doubt, you know, like, I'm thinking about branching out with Sushi Bites. You know, if I'm going to get them J-List advertising dollars, I'm going to have to start advertising the kind of things J-List sells. If I want a box of goods from Samurai Buyer to unbox, then, you know, like all them other YouTubers. Seriously, how come other people get a box of stuff to unbox from Samurai Buyer and I don't? I'm like the biggest weeb on YouTube. I should be guaranteed a box of anime goods. I vaguely recall this. Still ended up going this way. I'm convinced this is the mountains in question. You know what? I would love a box of stuff from Samurai Buyer to unbox if there was anything lewd in there, because I would be doing it on cam, showing myself. It would be the most embarrassing thing. Stop slicing me in the face. It would be the most embarrassing thing to open something out and go, ah, this is a dolphin massager. It would certainly be entertaining, and I'm sure it would be fun to watch as well. I'm pretty sure most of this game is bizarre. Of all the things to point out, geyser animations. Hate this area so much. What about this? Is this going to be any good? Yeah, there we go. We found our ultimate weapon. Of all the places to start, that's one of the stories you tell the grandkids. It's like, as he holds up a pair of Shima Pan, if he ever got a box. Oh my god, but the thing is, I would have to complete the act, you know, I would have to sniff them and everything. It would be really awkward. But it would be easy, because then I would know exactly what the thumbnail would be. It'd be a no-brainer. Should we start a change.org or a thunderclap to get this to happen? Should we get Masaki of Samurai Buyer to send me a box of interesting produce from Japan? Let's just say interesting produce from Japan. That's poison. Poison. Heart, which I can't reach. And a chest I can't reach. What? I can move. Oh! They move me upwards. Ah! Oh, I'm not going to be able to get that. That's okay. You know, I've heard about that. I've heard about that. I know that exists. Bludgeoning Angel Dokuro-chan game on Sushi Bites or the Lives. If it's Eroge, it's never gonna make the Lives. Although I have been really tempted to do some Eroge in the past for Sushi Bites Lives. I think this is one of those cases where I have to go to the boss level, and then I have to come back to get to the level where the stuff is that I need, like the key. A PS2 game. Alright, so it can't really be that bad then. Because there were generally sort of rules in place for the PS2. that made it hard for developers to do anything like that. I think the last console that was generally so open that you could publish anything on it was the Saturn, because I know the Saturn had a lot of RAGE on it. But I'm pretty sure it was the last console that really sort of openly accepted it. Although the PS3's got pretty close over the years, PS3 and PS4 with stuff like Natsuhiro High School and, you know, stuff like that. Why can't I... Oh, really? Oh, no. Fine. Guess I've got to play this level again. That's one annoying thing about this level, this game, is that you're never really sure where you're supposed to go in it. Oh great, I got poisoned. Oh excellent, I got antidoted. Nope, can't go any further. Right, okay, then I guess I have to go this way. Oh, wait, the name was familiar to me. Yes, that's the show where the main character keeps getting accused of being a pervert, so the angel beats him up with, like, the giant, spiked bat, and then always feels bad about it and revives him. Am I right? In which case, I remember the show was quite intense, like, quite violent, and I don't recall there being any nudity in it, but there was a lot of suggested stuff. I'm pretty sure that's right. I'm sure I've seen bits of it. Killer Queens. You'll have to tell me what that is. I've not heard of it before. Just type it on the laptop there. Final Fantasy Dawn of Souls. The Tale of Swords and Souls Eternally Retold. Well, it's got to be like the first route out of town. What? Where is this key? The problem is I did Worlds 1 and 2 so quickly because I knew where everything was in them. This world's proving harder because I really don't know where the boss key is. The guy said mountains, which is the main stage out of town, but... I didn't see it in the mountains. Oh, you've got bludgeoning angel, Dakuro-chan. It was amongst, like, I was given this huge list of shows to watch by someone I used to be quite friendly with. I still talk with them occasionally, but it's not quite the same these days. He said to me, you've got to watch bludgeoning angel, Dakuro-chan. You've got to watch, yeah, that's saved. You gotta watch Read or Die. He put me onto a lot of things, actually. Some stuff I didn't like okay, now I'm going the right way. Loads of stuff I didn't like I mentioned it on a previous stream, and it's completely gone from my head. This is how much I didn't like it. Like, my head is trying to forget it. Pink hair. Ooh, I'm a cat woman, and I'm going to kill people with invisible arms. Ooh. Elfin Lead. That's it. Not to be confused with Elfin Laid, while we're on the subject of other adult anime. Hate this mole, he's such a jerk. Killer Queen was a visual novel, originally for PlayStation 2.
Battle Royale. Oh, now you see, I liked Battle Royale. I thought that was a really good film, and I liked the theme in it.
It was really clever. Because you could believe it in a few years, given like overpopulation in the world, you could believe like the events of Battle Royale to be something that would actually happen. Especially with Japan sort of, it's a lot less severe as it was, but their sort of dislike of their youth and the way that their youth were acting. So it's interesting. It had a really good story, and I like the idea behind it.
Yeah, puppy murder and other questionable, horrible things.
Make it stop. Yeah, I wasn't really big on that show for, I think, obvious reasons. But, you know, each to their own. When she wasn't such a freak, Lucy was quite nice. When she was a freak, I really, really, really didn't like her. Let me guess, I gotta be up there to get the... to get the key. Yeah. That's where the key is. What shows do you get big on? Hi Cosmo, what do you mean by get big on? Because that could be misconstrued. I would probably answer both meanings of that question, depending on how drunk I am. So, Cosmo, I've been doing a lot more sushi bites as of late as well. I point that out to you because I know that you were also one of my many viewers that catches each episode. I'm sure you've already seen them. It was up here I was supposed to get, wasn't it? Yeah. I'm not going to make that mistake again. This time I'm not going to make it. I just love how you nonchalantly say what your favourite one is and just, like, drop it straight in chat. You know, I would never do such a thing, Koyahime. Okay, this time I'm not gonna make the same mistake as before. It's gone completely silent now. Right. I've got to remember how this level looks as I'm getting up to the section where I got to stay on the poles, so I don't make the same mistake again. Right, this is where I got to be and not fall off. Nope. Yep. Nope. Oh yes, of course, the debug menu for Bloody Roar. Well, the thing is, the debug menu in Sonic 2, I'd have to do, like, at some point, a Sega Tales on it, because there's some interesting things in it. Like, the Sonic community were getting really annoyed, because people were joining, like, the forums and going, I found this thing in Wing Fortress, I don't know if you've ever seen it before, but it's like this little small stick thing that wobbles, and I think it's a new discovery. And it's just someone who's been in, like, the debug menu for 5 minutes. Everybody knows about the little small sort of black wiggling thing in Wing Fortress, but, like, everybody who's new to the forums, like, says, I found this thing and I don't know what it does. Like, everybody else is just, like, sick and bored of it. Well, Sega Tales, I was planning one recently based on the... Oh, I've actually managed to waste a life here. Great. On the Tails doll. There's this myth that sort of predates the classic understanding and definition of creepypasta. There's this sort of creepypasta about the Tails doll that I was gonna do a Sega Tales on, by actually staying up until past 3 o'clock, as the original myth says, going to my bathroom with a camera and filming myself singing Can You Feel the Sunshine backwards at the bathroom mirror, and I just never got around to doing it. I would definitely love to do it. Sonic Dreams Collection, yes, that completely real collection of Sonic games produced by Sega. Completely real. Now, I love Sonic Dreams Collection. It's made by a studio called Arcane Kids. They did Bubsy3D.com, Bubsy Goes to the James Turrell retrospective, which was really awesome. They did Perfect Stride, which I really want to play. I've been keeping my eyes out for it, but I've not seen it on Steam ever. And it's genuinely like the best first-person game I've seen in my entire life. And I really want to play it. They did that. They did Room of a Thousand Snakes, which was really good. Alright, Cosmo. Well, take care. And thank you for joining me on this stream as well. Thank you for getting involved in the questionable chat. I'm not sure how long I'll be going anyway, depending on when Soy's streaming, I think. In about 30 minutes or so. I'll probably stop in enough time for his stream, but we're definitely going to beat this boss first. Right, full health before the boss battle as well. This is great. Now I'm just going to save here, because I might as well now. I'm abusing save states. And take on this boss. Okay. Nope, this does not ring a bell. I never got this far. So I really don't know what to expect. But this Barney the Dinosaur reject can bugger off. He's not proving very difficult to kill, though. Got him. And where's the stuff gonna fall? Right on the top there. Alright. Are those pants or legs? I don't know. I didn't have enough time to ask him before I beat the living crap out of him. Right, onto the next world. I definitely have never got this far before. Ooh, optional routes as well from the beginning of town. This is gonna be interesting. Okay. Upwards. That looks like a town. Bound to be someone friendly here. Okay, no. More of these birds that chuck poison. You know what? I am so desensitized, I didn't see anything unsuitable about the boss's, like, the previous boss's attack. All that is that I've completely ruined you, my audience. That's what it is. I've made you see these things where they're not really there. Boss reminds you of Sonson, just not scrolling. It's funny, because Soy and I, we give each other challenges, games to play, and I was tempted to give us TurboGrafx and PC Engine as a challenge system again, but we ultimately went for PSP this time, which is going to be interesting. But if we had gone TurboGrafx, I would have given Soy Sonson 2 to play, but I ultimately decided against it. However, if we do PC Engine another time, PC Engine and TurboGrafx at some point in the future, you'll probably get Sonson too from me, Soy. Although it would be worth me covering it on this show, just because there's a load of hidden stuff in it. Like, there's a load of hidden stuff in the TurboGrafx Sonson 2. Like, there's a black and white mode, there's like a classic graphics mode, there's a hard mode, there's an easy mode, and they're all like hidden by button combinations. Well, I'll tell you what I picked for Soy. We both went Japanese this time, which is interesting. I gave him Monha Poku Poku Eru, which is the Monster Hunter game with the cute cats in it. And he gave me... I'm trying to remember the name and I can't. By the way, who would put this many, like, blades in a school? What's wrong with these people? There's probably, like, something hidden here while we're going. Yeah, in the doorways. Okay. Please don't tell me I missed the key then. Cash. I get the feeling I've missed the key. A blue key. That's not quite the key I was looking for. No. But it's a start. Maybe you've got a clue where it is. The road ahead leads to a prison, but it's very dangerous. The road leads to a prison, but it's very dangerous. I would think that you would assume that the road to a prison would be dangerous to begin with. Also, check all the doors there. One may be open. Okay. One may be open. Well, my friend, that means we've got to find that one open door. One... Are you open? Are you open? Are you open? Are you open, Annie? Do I literally have to check every door? Yeah, we visited Alcatraz. An actual prison. I'm wondering if this cartoon actually had a prison in it originally, or if this is just, like, developers who are really fascinated by prisons for some reasons. I don't know. Okay! Okay. We were in a prison. I've opened the door, and we're in black background, melty clock, fuck it. No, sorry. I just need to check. Am I warm? Am I hyperventilating? Am I dreaming this? Am I dreaming this? Okay. It was just a bit unexpected is all. I'm gonna carry on. Let's carry on. I certainly was not expecting this. I'm gonna be honest. This was certainly peculiar, but I'm not gonna rule it out. Maybe this prison has a hole in space-time. That's gotta be the only explanation, surely. Right. Okay. Okay. back to the school. Let's go back to the start of town and go this way. All right. I'm certainly confused, but I'm not going to act like, you know, this is, you know, unlike a Japanese developer to do. They do this sort of weird stuff all the time. Just play like any old Taito arcade game. And you're bound to come across weirdness sooner or later. Especially Puli Rular. Now, there was a game that I wanted to do on Sushi Bites. And back in the old rules, I couldn't. Because it got an arcade release outside of Japan. But the great thing is that now the new remit allows me to do Puli Rular. So.
That's going to be quite inspiring, I think. Right. Inside this circus. Open sesame. Okay, I don't want to go in that door. Let's keep on going. Great. Lost a life. Now, there is a rewind function in this emulator, and I'm going to use it. Because there's no way I'm... Yeah, there's no way I'm letting it cheat me out like that. Where's the rewind? Oh, come on, I know it's in this emulator. I know I've seen it. Yeah. Seeing as I didn't have a save state there. How the hell did you not notice that? But it's right there in the word! Open sesame, open sesame. Come on! Seriously, you didn't notice that before. I didn't until about 2 years ago. So yeah, I can understand that. Okay, what do you want? Check above the fourth lamppost in this area for the red key. Well, that's specific. Thank you. That helps me out a lot more. Check above the fourth lamppost in this area for the red key. Fourth lamppost, okay. How high above are we talking? Like, can I get that high? Can I get that high? Seriously? Did I just say that? Really? Oh, good. It falls down to the ground. That's okay. Right, I'm gonna have to do the circus bit again, but... At least now I got the red key. I don't have to worry about that now. I know where the red key is, and I got it. Go ahead and do a Sushi Bites parody. My friend Chuck95 was saying he wants to do Sushi Yums as a parody of my show, just like making fun out of me. Go ahead. I've always held the belief that impersonation is the sincerest form of flattery. That to me it would be flattering for. Okay, I think somehow I've... Ah! No, it's continuing to... No! 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 No, it's going back! No! Ah! Whew. Hi, Project Carthage. You've caught pretty much the end of the stream, but... Welcome. I think that's not the first time you've done that. You must be really desperate to get high, Zero Escape. What? Zero punctuation. I was thinking about doing an impersonation set of videos a while ago. Like, I was going to impersonate the people on YouTube that I don't like, as well as the people on YouTube that I like. Sort of as a way to show them respect. So I was considering doing, you know, an Ashens parody. I was going to do a Jim Sterling parody. Basically all these people that I could probably pull off really easily. Gaming Anarchist, I reckon I could do a really good impression of him. I wanted to do an AVGN impersonation with the white shirt and the pens in the pocket. Basically these parodies that are not meant to cause offense, that they're meant to be sort of seen as harmless flattery, of the person in question. Guru Larry, I was going to do a Guru Larry one. And more recently, I've discovered I Hate Everything, and I'd be interested in doing a parody of his channel as well. Also discovered NFKRS, or Nuffuckers, recently, and I'd like to do an impersonation of him as well. Hello guys, it's Nuffuckers! Blaze Army! Yeah, that impersonation would need work, but generally I think there's a lot of YouTubers I'd be interested in impersonating. So, the long and short of it is, if you want to do an impersonation of me and do a parody video, by all means, do it. That would be awesome. Duh, plant! I feel sorry for him because, you know, he was really annoyed with Crikey Cameron in the first place, and that's why, you know, he made that comment. But he sort of shot himself in the foot by saying, "I'll see you next week when Der Plant is a meme." He shot himself in the foot with it by letting that happen. Now, you see, I'm not a huge Jim Sterling fan. I disagree with a lot of the things he said over the years and the sort of people that he's been associated with, but in terms of how much he stands up for the consumer, I have nothing but utmost respect for the guy. So I would love to do an impersonation of him. Hello, my jizz gurgling chuckle brothers, and welcome to a Squirty Plays. You know, it's a very easy voice to do because it's so very played up and over the top. I reckon it would be easy to do. God, this thing's terrifying. It's a giant fireball that shoots fire. Should I be terrified? If that was how he acted in Lisa, then it's a perfect representation of him. Very much so. His parts in Jazz Punk were very much what he's like as well. Make my monster grow! Jazz Punk is one of those games I hate to like, but I like it all the same. I hate to like it because a lot of the people involved in it, and there's a lot of sort of backhanded everybody who's a friend of the developer was involved in the project in some way. You know, very based a lot in cronyism, but I liked it all the same. It was a fun game. Oh, this is looking pretty serious. I might be near the end of the game. Crap. Gorosu Castle. There's no way I can leave things undone now, is there? Well, my dad must be in the castle. That's the logic that I'm following, so we're gonna do that. Dad's in the castle, must be. Well, I know that there's a lot of interesting themes in Lisa. Like, I'm pretty sure it's a game where, like, you can, like, chop your arms or legs off to pay for things and stuff like that. So, I dread to think what his cameo in it is altogether, but I imagine it's very awkward. I'm curious. What is his cameo in Lisa the Painful RPG? Alright, take care, Soy. I'm probably going to end up playing the rest of this game, and then we'll probably raid you. I'm not big on Crystallis anyway, so I'm happy to miss, like, the first
10 or 15 minutes. She'll be setting up anyway in the first five, so... take care, and I will... I will catch your stream when this is over. You have a Sailor Moon mug, Paper Mario TTYD Fan 1. Well, that's all well and good, but I have a Bleach mug. I got it for my birthday this year, and I refuse to ever put a drink in it. It's so awesome that I refuse to put any drink in this mug. It's far too cool for that. So it just sits on my desk. It's not the coolest thing on my desk, though. I have all three Baby Metal Pop Rocks Funko Pop figures. Well, I'm going to see them in April, so... If I ever did, like, Sushi Bites on music, there would definitely be a huge temptation to do Baby Metal. I think that's around about what my brother paid for my Bleach mug. It was around about that. My Sonic mug was less expensive, but I keep that one at work. Jim Sterling's cameo. He's a slave lord that makes you jump off a cliff, humiliates you by calling you sexy boy, fits you in a degrading dress, makes you drink glue in which you get high, and fights you. He also makes a young boy commit suicide. That sounds like Jim Sterling 100%. So at least they got his character right. A Sonic X mug saying gotta go fast. No, it's a retro Sonic mug, and it has like Get a Life written on it, and it's him staring at a 1-Up monitor, sort of like, is this really what I look like, sort of thing. It says Get a Life Sonic established 1991 on it. Yeah, it's the classic Sonic 1 sprite of him sort of waiting, tapping his foot. Now, like I said, I may not like some of the people that he hangs with, and I may not like the way he talks about some people, but generally he has a lot of care for the consumer. He cares a lot about people getting ripped off, and I generally think there is a nice person inside Jim Sterling somewhere. Which is why an impersonation of him for my YouTube channel would still be, you know, a form of flattery rather than an insult. The next areas will be even harder than before. If you don't stay alert, the Emperor will surely defeat you. The Emperor. As in, I am the one who rules over nature. I will hate and destroy mankind. I am the Emperor. I am. Yeah. Classic. Well, if he's anything like the Emperor, all we gotta do is shoot the center of the screen, and we'll pretty much beat him, so. Easy. I can't believe how short this game is once you make your way around the map world. Like, it really doesn't seem that long. I suppose because I knew where to go in worlds 1 and 2, that did help. But it's only like 5 worlds, and the 5th world is pretty much in a straight line. You don't have to get a key or anything, by the looks of things. My Emperor, I have failed you. I think that's how I started that Sushi Bites vlog, which was very important because it put things into perspective for me doing that. You notice that straight after that vlog, I released like 3 episodes of Sushi Bites. Well, 1 episode and 3 minis, just immediately, straight afterwards. I was so determined. The Emperor's castle at last. Once you go in, you won't be able to get out. You must go and save your father. I'll pray the gods to protect you. I hope you will. Gorosu Castle. Here it is. I'm assuming the last level of the game. And it will be much harder than the previous areas, I've been told. It doesn't seem that much harder yet, like... It doesn't seem that tough. You're not so tough! There is a lot of precarious jumping, though, I'll give them that. Right, I basically got to open every chest I see, because I've got 7 keys left. I got to make use of them. I'm a huge Star Fox 64 fan, so... Well, it was known over here as Lilat Wars. I'm really looking forward to the Wii U Star Fox, like, massively looking forward to it. I don't care much about Star Fox Guard. I think that's a lost cause, personally. Bit of a waste of time. What happened to Project Golem, or whatever it's called, the big game where you're the giant robot, like, why isn't that part of Star Fox? Or is it? Is, like, the final boss of Star Fox going to be in that giant robot? And it's Fox McCloud fighting Shigeru Miyamoto, because Shigeru's like, no, we will not have Crystal and Tricky in the game, and Star Fox is like, but I want Crystal and Tricky in the game, or something. I don't know. Right. I'm guessing we're on our way to the throne room. I'm just gonna... That sounded wrong. To the room where the King's throne, the Emperor's throne, is situated. Well, you know, he's an equal opportunities employer. He's employing all the all the diverse elves. I'll leave it at that. Ah! The decorations of... Oh, you can't jump on the red floor. Curious. That's gonna make things very awkward. Now we've got sand that you move slowly in. Oh, come on. All right. Still not boss time yet? Okay, well, I guess that we're right, these areas will be harder. Do I really need any more keys, though? I'm kind of hoping there's just like a room full of doors on the way to the boss, like a room full of chests, and you just open them all up. And it's like infinite health for the final boss, or something. Health and safety regulations. Oh my god, Keshi Head, no. Please stop. It's too painful. Besides, they prefer the term PORG, person of restricted growth. How very un-PC of you. Hmm. Come on, it can't be that long now, surely. Good, let the cringe flow through you. Ah yes, Emperor Palpatine. From one of George Lucas's 10,000 re-edits of the Star Wars movies. God, there's still more! For a game called Aoi Blink or Blue Blink, there sure is not so much Blink in this. Like, why can't I be Blink all the time? I know that would probably make the game way too easy, but come on, you're calling the game Blue Blink and I'm not even allowed to be Blink? Ah, get up! Get up, Guitar Man! There we go. Oh, there's another game I can do now. I've changed the... Get up! Change the rules of the show. I can do Guitar Man now. Oh, there's an idea. Oh, great. It's turned into a bullet hell now. How very, like, Bowser Castle in Mario Bros. 1 to be moving to the right and there be projectiles coming towards you. Ah! Ah! Welcome back. Okay. Just magicians appearing out of nowhere? If that's the case, I'm gonna have to switch to somebody who can deal more damage. Okay, this has gotta be it, surely. Yes! This looks like the end of the game to me. Right. Does he say something when he throws those barbershop poles at me? Oh no, that's just the sound of like the magic balls I'm throwing. This guy doesn't seem so tough with like three extra lives on hand. Oh, I see. The color of his star is how much health he's got left. In which case, there's still a while before he's defeated. Dark orange. Very dark orange. I've almost got him, surely, right? Oh no. Death. Well, now I know he takes 1,000 hits to defeat. Maybe I'll be a little bit careful about how much damage I take on this first run. If I use the heal by myself, yeah, it heals more. Okay, that's good to know. I'll keep an eye on that. If you use the heal function yourself, instead of letting your health run down, you get more health back. Knowing that, I think this isn't going to be too tough.
tell you, I don't know of many emperors that can levitate. It's probably been given one of them magic rings that has a little bit of the Philosopher's Stone on it. Just for extra power. Oh, great. I really should have used my revival there. I'm sort of implying that he's like Cornelio or whatever his name was. What an absolute con artist that guy was. Alright, okay. Gotta get him here. I gotta get him now, otherwise I gotta start over the boss battle again. Got him! What's the point if I can't spend this? Whatever. Is it done? Did I beat the game? What? Oh, okay. Dad! Keiru! You did it, Keiru! But not without a little help from my friends! Thanks for saving me. If you hadn't defeated the Emperor, he'd have ruled the world. Keiru defeated the Emperor because of courage and his friends helping. I want to always value that courage and friendship. Why was such a small group able to defeat the Emperor? It was because of deep friendship. If they had tried to fight alone, they would have lost. Strength bonded in friendship gives people much more power. It was this power of friendship that led Keiru to victory. Thank you for playing. No, thank you. And here he is, stroking his unicorn pony friend. I swear, the themes are there. If you ever watch the show, keep an eye out for the very not subtle themes in the cartoon. I don't know what he's meant to be looking at. It's just a blue screen. Though, to be fair, I can probably clip that out and use that green screen style. Alright, great game. Friendship is magic. Okay, we get it now. Yes, the themes of friendship are very strong, just like in a certain children's cartoon involving ponies. Special thanks to all these people. Thanks, people. You were great. Well, it's very unusual for me to beat a game on a live stream. Presented by Hudson Soft. I guess that means Konami has the rights to this now. There'll probably be a patchy slot. AOI Blink, erotic violence. Hit the lever. End. Well, that was pleasant enough, wasn't it? Nothing overtly offensive in that game. You know, the whole time I have had the actual artwork for the game underneath this, but like, I just thought this fit better, you know, with the general theme. Ah, his head moved. Okay, we're done. We did it. We did AOI Blink. You know, if I did any more PC Engine soon, I would probably take a shot at another translated ROM. What was it that stood out to me earlier? This. I'm not going to do it now, though. I'm going to see if Soy's streaming. But, this is what I might do another time, so I'll just leave that going while I have a look to see if Soy's now live. And if he is, we're gonna annoy him.
They're all
pretty. Yeah, he's already started. Excellent. Okay. We're gonna go raid that poor soul with a hashtag. Blue space pony raid. I'm running out of ideas now. Blue space pony raid. Okay, guys. Blue space pony raid. poor Soy. I wanna see this. I wanna see the first one up there, and then I'll drop mine in the chat. Yeah, okay. Unmute it. So I can hear him.
Week. So
alright guys, thanks for joining me. Yeah, next one will be Bubblegum Crash at some point in the near future. Anyway, take care and thanks for watching. Peace out.
Yeah.